most people fear more than anything else. No, 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 not that. Not that. No, 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 not that. Much more than that, they fear being called weird, of not fitting in, being an outcast. As delightful as it is, no one wants to be exiled to the island of misfit toys. No. You know what people crave more than anything in this whole wide world? This whole being human thing? Like one of a kind. Oh, whoever said humans make sense or are rational was some kind of joker, or maybe delusional. They were playing with you. I don't say this to many people. No, I can't even remember the last time. You really are special. You really are one of a kind and original. You know what I mean? That's exactly how a truly special person would react. Not at all. No reaction. You know who you are. And you're totally cool with it. You know you're a weirdy, and you wouldn't have it any other way. Now would you? You probably can't imagine being any different in the way you are. The world needs more people like you. I mean, not just like you. The world only needs one you, but more like you. Not afraid to be weird, to be 100% original. You know you're the only person who answered our ad. Well, the only bona fide, special, one-of-a-kind outlier, anomaly person. Sure, we had lots of people come in here squealing, oh, look at me, I'm so weird, I put sriracha sauce on everything, even PB&J Sammy's, or no one's weirder than me because I paint each toe a different color, or I'm so weird I can never sleep in the same pajamas. I'm weird because I'm ambidextrous. Or, oh, it's so out there to have a 50-pound tinfoil ball. Or, whoa, look out, I'm so weird. I bathe in my own pee and dandelions, and I only shower once a month. That's not weird. That's just gross. Anyway, you are straight out of a Robert Crumb comic book weird. And screw the world. The aesthetic army needs you. The army of weirdos. That cringe, that recoil. I expected that. We expected that. The last thing a rare bird like you, a lone ranger, a free spirit, wants is to joining is not in your repertoire, is it? Not if you fit the profile of a true individual. If you fit that profile, you've been terrified of groups and organizations, anything with a recruitment process and eligibility criteria from the womb. You've been scared of anything with protocols and a mission statement. You're well versed in history, so you know to avoid anything that has some grand narrative and some big ideas. Anything that's propelled by zeal and fervor. So, yeah, we know we're gonna have to work hard to convince you to link up your talents with anyone beyond you, yourself, and you. I know you won't believe me if I tell you this is your destiny. You don't believe in destiny, possibly, or you believe in destiny, but you believe it's a private, confidential matter, a secret you keep with you and yourself. You do. And you know that you have one. That makes my job so much easier. So, I just need to convince you that your destiny and your mission line up with the aesthetic army, that they jive. Just give me a minute. Just want to take a look at this flow chart. Okay. Does the weirdo believe in destiny? If no, then issue an appeal to them for their unique skills that no one else possesses. Alright, it's not that. If yes, weirdo does believe in destiny. Okay. Present one or all of the following scenarios. Scenario A. Imagine that your weirdness had been brutally oppressed and never allowed to express itself. Appeal to the weirdo. Appeal to the weirdo to find it within themselves to help rescue other weirdos trapped and held captive by normies. Just a second. Think of all the people who need your help. That's one appealing thing. Or you can say, probably you can't imagine your life without your special destiny. Okay. Confidence is that destiny. You're probably very confident that that destiny helped you embrace your weirdness. Could you please spare some time and energy to help others get in touch with their own destinies? Scenario B. Alright, if said weirdo possesses a vision of a world shaped by higher frequency aesthetes, people with better taste, okay, you appeal to the weirdo by saying, do you realize how much of an impact it would have if people such good taste like yours were able to have greater influence on the world around us. Ask the weirdo to imagine how many lives could be positively affected if they shared their special talents and their higher level tastes with the world. Ask the weirdo to imagine how they could team up with others to put a new paint job on society. If there were a band of weirdos working together as as individuals, but in parallel with a concerted mission. Scenario C, if the weirdy is resentful towards normies or the mainstreamers, ask them to think how and imagine how pissed off the mainstreamers will be if they rescue other weirdies from the clutches of the normies, the mainstreamers. Which one's it going to be? I don't know how to decide which one's going to be the right appeal. Oh, you heard all of that? So what do we do now? What do I do now? You are? You are interested in learning more about our organization? You don't say. What's our specific vision for society? Where do I even start? Well, just speaking from the heart, everything you see around you was built out of human necessity. One could even say fear, like knee-jerk impulses, like fear, insecurity, yeah. Not all of it, but much of it. So it's jerry-rigged, it's slapdash, it's ugly, it's wonky in places, it's off-key for the most part. Then there's all that stuff out there that just didn't come from the heart, like houses, buildings, products. They weren't passion projects, let's get real. So they're just functional at best, and all of this was designed by people who don't understand sarcasm or irony, and that is a crying shame. So much of it is just way too in earnest and saccharinely sweet, and it lacks emotional depth, and sorry, I'm just rambling. I'm just like a little nervous because I really want to convert you. I really want to enlist you. I want to bring you over. I can't articulate it succinctly or smoothly. Maybe you could just read our mission statement. But personally, I dream about a world where a person could live the life they really want to live. You step outside and no two people look alike, not even vaguely or remotely. No two houses look alike. No two cars could be mistaken for each other. Everyone is dressed to fully express their own individual personality. Can you imagine? Can you imagine? World where everyone gets to live the life they want to live and put their imprint, their stamp on everything in their environment, everything around them. Like, everyone custom designs their own clothes, designs their own hair, their own everything. Own bags, their imagine if parking garages were art galleries. And freeway underpasses too. And imagine, can you imagine if every time you stepped outside there was something fresh, exciting, something scintillating to look at. Because everyone was so busy expressing themselves. And can you imagine what it would be like if it were true that you can never walk down the same street twice because the scenery is always changing. Because people are adding to it and tweaking it. And now, this could sound elitist to some people. Unique, groovy, funky tastes were designing everything you see around us. Not cookie cutter people. There were bursts of creativity and originality just splattered all around us. No molds, no assembly lines, no fast fashion. The world would just be a canvas for you, for me, to put our signature. We could work together to empower people, even normies, to get in on this. Because within every normie, there's gotta be some original creative contribution just waiting to be released and unleashed and uncaged. Hear it? Some paperwork, but let's just forget the paperwork. That's too mainstream. Let's just have a brainstorming session in the morning, of course. Now you go to sleep. More aesthetically pleasing society, a more groovy, funky world. Okay, something like that. And we'll meet up tomorrow and we'll start getting some things in action. Just as weird, as wild, as exuberant and out of this world as you can imagine. It's gonna come through. Get a good night's sleep. And we're gonna brainstorm in the morning. We're gonna go over those blueprints in the morning. Alright. Now you go take your mugwort. I know you've got some mugwort in the cabinet somewhere. Groovy. Alright. Good night. And we cannot wait to work in parallel. Mediocre.